Do I need an accountant to do my self-assessment tax return, or can I take a crack at it myself? Stay tuned to find out. Hi there, Nicholas Campion here from First Summations. The subject of today's discussion is, do you need an accountant to do your self-assessment tax return, or can you tackle it yourself? And the short answer is, if your financial situation is fairly straightforward, you can most probably do your self-assessment tax return yourself without the need of an accountant. Assuming you are comfortable with using a computer, you can quite easily work out what is expected of you by HMRC, as the gov.uk website provides some very detailed instructions. The tax return itself is broken down into sections and pages. Each page saves automatically, and you can jump in and out of pages if you want to take a break to find information or do some calculations. From time to time, you may get an error message, but this is just a polite warning from HMRC telling you that the page is incomplete in case you try to submit it before it is completed. HMRC will also give you some guidance on what they're looking for. This is currently accessed by clicking the help feature below each question. Now, admittedly, some questions can take a few moments to grasp what is being asked, but as long as you do not leave the tax return to the last minute, it's entirely possible to do it yourself without an accountant, or at least give it a bash. Once you have completed but not submitted the tax return, you can take your time to review it before filing, giving you the added reassurance that what you've entered is correct. HMRC will ask you to confirm that you are ready to submit, which is done by entering your Government Gateway user ID and password again. This means it's very hard to submit it accidentally. If you do put your tax return aside to review at a later date, don't forget to go back and file it before the deadline of the 31st of January. Set a personal reminder if you need to. HMRC will consider it an unfiled return otherwise and charge you penalties and interest. Now, in terms of submitting your own return, there are a number of benefits of doing so. The most obvious one is the amount of money you will save on accountants' fees. The actual amount you save will vary depending on your location, type of business, bookkeeping needs, and the number of transactions in the year. But realistically speaking, you could be looking at saving in the region of £250 to £500 per year. Another benefit of doing your own tax return is the empowered feeling it brings. This may help you feel more capable of handling your own finances and give you the confidence to try new things that may help grow your business. So those are some of the benefits of doing the return yourself. And remember, we only recommend doing this if your financial situation is fairly straightforward. But just what does a straightforward tax return actually look like? Well, an example of a simple return would be one where you, as a director, receives a salary through the business. The salary would have been processed through payroll software, either by yourself or an accountant. Other items may include some dividends, bank interest, and perhaps a benefit in kind. The tax return would simply be the details of your P60, the end of year salary summary, which would show the gross salary that you received in the tax year and any tax paid. The dividends would be those that you received in the tax year 6th of April to the 5th of April. That's not your company tax year. The bank interest you received would be found on an annual statement from your bank each tax year. If it's unclear, simply call your bank. And the benefit in kind value would have been calculated by your company accountant, or yourself if you do your own payroll. However, if you have received additional income, for example property rental, the sale of assets, or you are eligible for entrepreneurial relief or any other reliefs, then things start to get more complicated here, and that's when it becomes advisable to use an accountant. This will help ensure that you declare the relevant information correctly and pay the right amount of tax. In terms of submitting your own return, you are not alone. There are several accounting systems on the market that can help you do your tax return, for example, FreeAgent and QuickBooks. Both are priced at the average rate a self-assessment accountant might charge annually, although FreeAgent is free if you have a NatWest, RBS or Metal Bank account. Now, there's a quick point here to make in relation to making tax digital for income tax. HMRC has announced that they want to see quarterly self-assessment tax return filings from the 6th of April 2023 onwards, as opposed to what it is currently, which is annually. If you rely on an accountant to do your tax return, their cost is likely to increase at this time. To mitigate this additional cost, it would be advisable to consider looking at how to do your return yourself. Furthermore, we also advise that you embrace cloud accounting software prior to this date. This will allow you to get to grips with the software prior to having to do these quarterly tax returns. Now, so far, we have looked at when and how you can do your own self-assessment return. As we've seen though, there are times when you really should be thinking about obtaining the services of a self-assessment accountant. And there are, of course, plenty of benefits of doing so. For example, an accountant can give you advice on financial challenges that you may face in your business. They can help you navigate through the salary versus dividend minefield. They can bring peace of mind knowing that you're doing things correctly. And of course, they can check your bookkeeping, ensuring that all sales and expenditures have been identified correctly. Accountancy software is a great help, but you can't rely solely on it to be accurate. Like any software, the data out, in this case your tax return, is only as good as the data that goes in, that is the data that you enter. If there are any errors in categorizing your sales and expenses, or if your bank connection duplicates or omits data, which does happen, although thankfully it is rare, then your tax return will be incorrect. Finally, here are some quick tips on how to reduce any errors in your return. Number one, check your bookkeeping software's bank balance with your bank statements. Number two, keep your personal bank account separate from your business bank account. And number three, ensure all personal expenditure or cash withdrawals from the business are categorized in the software as either dividends or, if you're a sole trader, drawings. And there you have it. In today's video, we have discussed the question, do I need an accountant to do my self-assessment tax return? We have found there are circumstances where you can do it yourself and save quite a bit of money in accountancy fees. There are, of course, other situations where using an accountant could be very beneficial, if not entirely necessary. You shouldn't be afraid to give this work to an accountant if you aren't comfortable doing it yourself, or if you have a complex return to deliver. Always try to remember the overarching rule of the self-assessment tax return, and that is to get it right. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And in the meantime, be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more advice on limited companies, reporting requirements, and tax obligations. We're always happy to hear from you, and we can't wait to help. Until next time, cheerio.